Hi everyone, good morning. How are you doing today? So my name is Prerna Makharia and I run a jewelry blog by the name Style Prayer. The website is www.styleprayer.com, and we're doing this session with Velvet Case today, which is an online marketplace for designers to list their jewelry and also for consumers to buy jewelry online. So this is our next video on while we talk about how you can package your jewelry, even if you're keeping it at home, so how you can store it, and even if probably when you're traveling, how in what kind of boxes or pouches that you can carry it so that it doesn't get damaged. So starting with the first kind of packaging, this is a plain chart paper. As you can see, I've made it rectangle and I've cut an equal size of butter paper. So butter paper it absorbs all the moisture, or if there's any kind of salt in the air or moisture in the air, butter paper doesn't let the jewelry get damaged. So what we do is, I'm sorry, my face will get hidden, but I'm going to try to show you this. We take a rectangular shape, maybe this size I'm using for a necklace, but you can use smaller ones even for smaller jewelry. This is basically called a palika in our jewelry language. So what we do is diamonders generally keep their diamonds in this, or we also keep jewelry in this so that it doesn't get damaged. Yeah, so talking about this, this is a rectangle shaped paper. So you need to fold it 1/4. So this is the first fold, and then you fold on the right a little bit on the left. This is your third fold. Okay, repeating first, second, third, then you roll it up, which is the fourth fold, and then you go it on, and then you go on top. That's the fifth fold. I'm going to repeat this again. You can anyways watch this on YouTube, so you can repeat the steps. Step number one, you fold it 1/4, then you fold it from the left to the right, 2, 3, 4, roll it up, and 5. So in this, what you can do is you can place your earrings, you can put your necklaces, but make sure when you're using earrings, they're typically flat earrings and not highly mounted, and all you have to do is just slip this in into your handbag. So this works great for necklaces. Then when you're storing jewelry at home, or maybe when you're traveling, you want to use this kind of a plastic box. So what I've done here to show you an example, at the bottom I have put cotton over here so that there's softness into the box, and then after that, on top of that, I've put muslin cloth, which is malmal ka kapda. So right now this is a colored one, or you can use a white one as well. So just showing you again, this is the cotton I've cut to the size of the box. I've placed it here. So this is a one-time thing, guys, you need to do. It's not that too much that you need to bother with this. You put the cotton, you put the muslin cloth of that size, and then you can place the jewelry there. So why I'm putting the muslin cloth on the cotton is because sometimes the lint from the cotton tends to get stuck into the jewelry. So I've put a muslin cloth, and then when I'm traveling, all I need to do is I'll just put another muslin cloth or a handkerchief on the top so that the jewelry is not seen. Another way what you can do in this is, boxes like these work very well, which have sections. So what I've done is I put my bangles together, I put earrings together, I put my rings together and pendants together. So you can either put function wise jewelry in different sections so that it's easy for you to recognize which jewelry, to identify which jewelry you want to wear for which function. Or even when you store it at home, your lightweight jewelry, your formal jewelry, and traditional jewelry all can be segregated in an easy way. So there are different sizes of boxes available. You can get them probably from your general store where you get stuff for your house. So even these kind of boxes work. I'm just showing you different shapes and sizes. This is typically a medicine box, a pill box that it's called. So you can get this at the medical store. There are smaller sizes in this. This works best for daily wear jewelry. So or even when you tend to just remove your jewelry at night, or maybe when you're traveling, you know, you just place your jewelry in this so that you don't lose it anywhere and you can carry it in your handbag. So butter paper works very well, you know, when you, so this is a smaller size. That was a bigger size because that was a necklace paper. This is a smaller one for smaller paper. What you can also do is Ziplocs also work very well. So, you know, sometimes you can use these kind of smaller Ziplocs once you place them in the butter paper, and then you can use these. So probably in my next video, I will show you how to put fashion jewelry or necklaces into Ziplocs, so that you know how to carry multiple long necklaces or medallions in a Ziploc like that. Then velvet pouches like these also work very well because they're soft and it doesn't let the jewelry get damaged in any way. Other than that, you can also use, you know, I've borrowed these from my mom. These make great for traveling or maybe storing at home. So the design is fancy, and then they have a lining inside which is quite soft. So this doesn't let the jewelry get damaged. And you know, you can probably again put them in, you can put them in Ziplocs, or you can put them on butter paper, and then you can put it in those pouches. The other way, another form is these kind of travel pouches are customized and they're made. Sorry, this is a little dirty, but just to show you, to give you an example. So it has you know, transparent plastic here, so that you know, when you're putting the jewelry, you can see what is inside, and so there is lining of cotton or sponge inside this, so that it makes it soft. And there are different sections made, so that, you know, for different kind of jewelry, smaller jewelry, bigger jewelry, necklaces, you can just place them in there. And another one I would like to show you is something like this, which works well for watches, for chains, or maybe for carrying long necklaces. These kind of pouches work very well. So they all have a lining, they have a sponge inside, which works great. So when I showed you something like this in the box, you can also put sponge in the bottom instead of cotton. Either of them works very well. And what you can do is, if you have any suggestions, if you have any tips where you can tell us that how you would want to package your jewelry and how you do it, and we could incorporate it in any way that we're doing it. So please feel free to comment below, to message me, and you can check our website. You can check Velvet Case and my website. It's www.styleprayer.com. You can also follow me on my social media, which is Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, which is at Style Prayer. And on Facebook, it's at Style Prayer Blog. And likewise, you can also check it on Velvet Case. So www.velvetcase.com. If you like any of the jewelry which I just showed you, so you can log on to that. And you can also follow their social media pages. And please feel free to connect with me. Please feel free to give your suggestion, your feedback, and your tips that you would like to recommend us, so I can incorporate that in the next video and help us improvise. Thank you so much. Do let me know how you like this video. Thank you. Bye bye. See ya. Have a great day.